In this video, we're going to create a banner in Job Editor. I'm going to start by opening my file into Job Editor directly. In preparation for this file, I need to rotate this 90 degrees, so I'm going to click on my Preview and Size tab, Rotate 90 degrees, and Apply. In this case, the file needs to be resized, so I'm going to change the image height to 36 inches. Now that I have the rotation and size set, I need to apply the bleed and grommet conditions. Those can be found in the Finishing tab. I'm going to enable my bleed, and I'm going to set the left and right bleed values only to 4 inches. So what I'm going to do is disable the lock, the link, and I'm only going to set the left and the right to 4 inches. Now you'll notice the bleed type is mirror, and what I need this to be is a color, and I need to match the background white. So I'm going to leave that default setting for a white background of the bleed color to match the background of the file. Now I can indicate any type of fold marks or corner marks. I'm going to turn on the banner corner marks. At this point, I'm ready to set my grommets. I'm going to click on my grommet tab, and the settings I need for my grommets are just for my left and right grommets. So I'm only going to enable the left and the right grommet settings. I can control the grommet placement by spacing or by quantity. I need these to be spaced 8 inches apart. I also need to set these grommets into the bleed area, so I'm going to turn on Place Grommets in Bleed Area. Furthermore, I want to set the top and bottom offsets so that they come in at 2 inches from the end. So I'm going to set that to 2 inches. Now my grommet placement is 2 inches in from the edge and a 1-inch offset up. If necessary, we can go to the Marks tab and we can enable a crop outline, which would help as a guide to trim this file down. Now that I have all of my settings here, I start to notice that this would make a very nice quick set, and in future uses, I can just apply the quick set and I don't have to do this manually in Job Editor. So it's going to save me time and keep me consistent. So now I can do this in my Job Editor. I can go to File, Export as a quick set. In the screen, I can set additional settings to those that I just set now if I choose to. I'm going to hit Save. I've got a special folder where I place my exported quick sets, and I'm going to give this a unique name that's going to identify what the purpose of this quick set is. I'll name it Banner and Save. Now that saved quick set will be imported into my quick set menu. At this point, I'm going to submit the job to the RIP, and now we see our completed file. I would print my banner, trim it down if necessary, apply my grommets to where those mark placements are, and I have a completed product. Let's go back and take a look and revisit how about importing that saved exported quick set. I would go to Configure Printer. That's going to stop my processing. And in my Quick Sets tab, I would simply import the quick set that I saved while I was in Job Editor. I'm going to browse to my folder structure where I saved the file, select that banner quick set, and open and import that into my standard quick set. Now I have that quick set to use time and time again. So let me demonstrate. I will open a file again, and this time, instead of going into Job Editor and making those manual changes, I will simply apply the quick set. Automatically, all those presets that I created will be applied, saving me time, keeping me consistent and repeatable. Now I have the same effects for my banner created as I did this manually in Job Editor. For more information on documents and videos, please visit our website at onyxgfx.com.